Hi.
John Manoa here in Waitangi on the 28th of October 2016. I'm here at the entrance, the back entrance to the Waitangi Marae, King's Bench Court, here in the Bay of Islands, New Zealand, Norfolk. Today is marking 182 years of this flag. Declaration of independence of this country at Kororareka, or now known commonly as Russia. There, the first British settlers in the Navy family and their craftsmen, tradesmen, landed on the 20th of March 1834. At that time, the chief of the time was called indigenous natives. They put up a fight because a lot of people was landing on this country all over the place, from France, Spain, England, Germany, and so on. So the chiefs petition to the King, William IV at the time of his reign, 1830 to 1837, that they wanted his protection from the British Parliament, government and military. So, James Busby at the time, he arrived here about 1830, around about then, and in 1833, the chief started designing this flag, the big one flag, and in 1834, James Busby had the flag constructed looking complete. Now, it wasn't gazetted through the New South Wales government in Australia. It had no right of sovereignty from Britain to be selling land to. Everyone who was selling land was illegally selling land to the natives. And so, in the time of Te Rā Waikato Whareherehere, and that's a Waikato chief from Maunga Kaukari in Cambridge, and Tongihika, chief of Ngāwhi in this area, went to England in 1820 and stayed there right up to 1833 before they came back. There they learned the tricks of the trade of commerce in Cambridge University. Te Rā Waikato Whareherehere had more interest in bank, native bank, native bank, and money side. And Tongihika was responsible as combat, military style, with muskets. The British taught both these chiefs English at Cambridge University, were taken care of in the British government at the time until King William recognised them as natives. In that time, they learned transactions, land transactions, and occupation titles, and combat and conquering countries or tribes of people who were going to hold them up when they got back here. So when Tongihika got back here, he came with a cache of muskets. And away he went shooting at will with the British to conquer the land. In the meantime, Te Rā Waikato Whareherehere from Waikato, from Cambridge, from Cambridge University in England, Cambridge in New Zealand here, at Maunga Kaukari Mountain, where the pā was of Esta, the chief of Esta. And Refere for Manukau, so tēnā waka ko whareheri e hiri e Manuka form the Manukau Pope. At that time, the Manukau Land Company was set up in Glasgow, Scotland. The Scottish were doing the land pipe. And so that's where that company started as corporate when it got here. But in the meantime, the land titles were in Australia, New South Wales, sovereign government. And they assumed the authority to sell them. And at the same time, the French wanted to do the same thing before 1835. So this flag, in 1834, when Captain J.R. Clinton proclaimed the land belonged to the King of England. That formed the first real estate from the Crown Corporation under the King at Kororareka, Russia. They set up the government because there was no government from Britain. They set up a straight sovereignty government there. And in doing so, the surrogate King picked up the flag and used it as the founding document of this country in 1834. As being the flag of New Zealand. From there, it was the flag of New Zealand right up to 1840, from 1834, not 1835. So in 1835, after James Busby had helped to set up the native corps with the chiefs, there was a British resident who helped marry, not marry, the native indigenous. To form a government, native government and native court. When the British president, J.R. Clinton, got here, he just made it legal to have a government set up in Russia for the Marae. That's through Honihiku and Te Rā Waitangi. Waikato and the Ngāpū. So that made the first mortgage land part of the land of the New Zealand. And so, Honihiku didn't like that idea of British flag up on Kororareka above his birth. And so he chopped down the flag. Well, four times the ship. So they had to go and get another one off the Marae. British HMS. HMS. Fortitude. Was a ship in them. And then, in 1835, a year later, on this day, 28th of October 1835, this flag became the Declaration of Independence. Founding documents of a confederation of chiefs all over the country. So the first mortgage was at Kororareka, Russia, with Russia, with Clinton. And the second mortgage, that was in this Marae, right in Marae. And the second mortgage was at Fatima, at 1835. 1834 here, 1835 there. Alright, get that? And so in 1835, it now became the New South Wales titles were seized by the British and reissued to the Manukau Land Company in Auckland, the Manukau title, on the land of Pupuku, Pa, at the Manukau Head, through the Te Rā Waikato Whareheri, and therefore the Manukau, the son of that chief. Okay, got that? So now, we had a parliament set up, British parliament set up in Auckland under these new issue titles. At the same time, that was John Rogan, was the judge in Helena, now that title under the Manukau became the new title, straight to the top. In Glasgow, the Manukau Land Company was a Crown Corporation company, straight from the top. Okay? And so now that was the title I'm talking about. And the bank note followed in 1888, the King Tafia pound note in that era. Okay? So, he had the pound note running from 1888 to 1933, right before 1934, when this British started to take over. That's when, at the time, the BNZ started printing. They had a printer to print notes, and they took hold of the British notes that King Tafia was buying, was costing more to buy the notes straight from the Britain, and then sell the notes, whereas the BNZ had a printer. That's when the Akaroa Bank was set up in Hillingford. That's coming still under the Manukau title. To the Waikato, but ahead of his interest in banking and native court. So now I'm just telling you the story of this flag inside this marae as a Kingsman's Court for the whole world. This flag will save the whole of the country that the Queen made after King William died. Queen Victoria was taken over by the Rothschild banks in the family of the Bell, who controlled the Bank of England and the pound notes. And reissued the pound notes to all the countries they conquered, the same conquering again, carried on under the Queen. So what we're doing here is holding the Queen to account of the King's Bench Court here, from the side there to the Marae, and put it into perspective of today's commercial world, which this flag is a commercial flag, the only king's commercial flag in the world, to save the rest of the world, and including Britain and America, from martial law. This is martial law. We put the legal back into English. I tell you what, on the 15th of April, 2015, we put the legal back into it. And enforced it back into law, or what it was meant. Commercial trading bank flag of the king. That's why I'm wearing these coat of arms here, and King William's photo here, and the seal of the New World Order here, with the 8-point star, the Pope and the Maui seal. Both seals, Marae seal, memorial, and King William's seal, memorial here, of his Admiralty ship and his crew, and him sitting on the ship. And it's raised on this side, here, the British flag, King William's crown and anchor, Admiralty flag, and our Marae flag, and the Confederation flag here. That's four flags. To make up our commercial contract with England, it's still a contract right back to 1834, not 1835, 1834. This is 1835 here on Te Tī Marae and 1834 here in this one. Waitangi Marae, 1834. Te Tī Marae, 1835. Australian title. All Australian titles, yeah. John Key's 1840 treaty of this with no end date on it means it's not a contract, but no end date. Right? This one with King, forever. It's forever. No one can change it, only us. We can end the date on it when we walk into this marae on 6th of February. We're going to proclaim the land belongs to the chief and not to the queen. That's what we're going to do today. Proclaim the land belongs to the chief, not the king or queen. Right? However, Crown's got its own ideas, the Crown in Wellington, not the Crown in Britain, the Crown in Wellington. I spoke to the British High Commission assistant yesterday. Put this on the record. Put it on record, for the record, that we were going to proclaim today, 182 years of this day, still lie conquered. No one can entertain it, or temper of it, between us and the King of England. Okay? No one can enter into a private contract. That's what an Admiralty is, private contract, not entry. So that's the story I wanted to tell you. I have Paul Tupia here from the Kirikiri police station. Constable came down to just check again to make sure there wasn't going to be any trouble. So there's no trouble because I've already made it up for what our intention is. Our intention it should have happened because we have the authority to do that on this, and it was the co-mother to make the decision about what should happen and what should not happen here today. Okay, so I'm not disappointed, I'm just informing them of their rights of this flag, and it looks like none of them know much more than what I told them, that it's a trading flag. If you're not trading, it's not effective. It's only there to wave around that they want to talk to me. I'm doing all the talking online to tell the world that this flag is still alive between us and Britain, and it's our contract by default of the Queen exiting and abandoning the ship and gone into the EU Parliament with NATO to conquer the world some more. And it's falling to pieces with the Clinton administration, the Clinton Foundation, and Obama. The ship coming in. So my concern today was the ship coming in, the nuclear ship, into Auckland Harbour. Where that ship goes, it takes its troubles of war. Everything the Queen has done is war in conquering people and taking their land by force. Of they're using financial martial law now to shoot on sight if you don't hand over your gun and your land. That's coming out of this one. Obama gets his authority from the Queen, who gives the King's authority to shoot him on sight and hang him and steal their land and their assets and their natural resources. That's from the native title that these two chiefs, Terawatapo Karahere Manukau, Terawatapo Karahere Manukau, and Hongihik chiefs put the native title together for all the indigenous native countries in the world. Okay, so that's all I want to say today. I'm going to go back and have my cup of tea at the Marae and listen to some more talk, and that's my day. I'll go back to work. Not completely what I can hear. But the flag up the top of the pole. Which is on this ship. The flag staff on the Team Marae, on the Waitangi Marae, is the British ship. So this flag should be up the top, the King flag should be on. At the moment, the Union Jack's up there. As John Key tried to get rid of it and put the firm up for his own financial interests. Investment interest and not that of the public community. So this is a real flag for the King. The only one in the world that made the cross and the caps of the country and pound notes. So that's the story for today. I'm going to go now back to the Marae and I'll have 5 minutes from the Marae to Waitangi, Northland, New Zealand.